after the ayahuasca is when she flipped. That's when she kind of like started going off the deep end.
This person is very dangerous and she has already threatened to kill me, and I'm trying to save my life.
She was so blissful, she was so sweet, and then she turned into an absolute narcissistic monster.
Born Catiúcia Torres Soares on October 24th, 1992, in Belém, Brazil, Cat Torres's beginnings were far from the glamorous life she would later live. She grew up in poverty with an alcoholic father and a sickly mother, leading her to dream of escaping her dire circumstances and living a better life. From a young age, Cat stood out with her distinct style. She always wore red lipstick and styled her hair in a bob, reminiscent of Coco Chanel. Because of her good looks and height, she was often advised to try modeling, which the young girl took as an opportunity to escape her unfortunate situation. She began as a model for fashion brands in Brazil, eventually joining local beauty pageants. This led to her receiving a life-changing offer from a modeling agency that brought her to Europe when she was 18. In Milan, Italy, the statuesque beauty quickly became a household name in lingerie and swimsuit modeling. Her career took her all over the world for photo shoots and opened doors to celebrity-studded parties and exclusive social circles. In October 2013, she made headlines when rumors spread about a possible relationship with renowned Hollywood actor Leonardo DiCaprio after they were photographed in Cannes together. The Brazilian media latched onto the story, even calling her DiCaprio's new blonde girl. Cat eventually denied any romantic involvement after previously claiming they were dating, but the publicity had already helped boost her name. She took advantage of this moment and went to the US in December 2013 to try her luck in acting. This career path was unsuccessful, but she continued to find work as a model. The ambitious woman kept residences in Los Angeles and New York, traveling back and forth for photo shoots and fashion shows. Although she was living abroad, her celebrity status in Brazil continued to grow throughout 2014 as she landed major projects with brands like Victoria's Secret, L'Oreal, and Gillette. During this year, she also began reinventing herself as a lifestyle influencer. Under the Instagram handle Kata Luz, she shared beautiful photographs of her travels and life in New York and Los Angeles. Kat's social media painted a picture of a luxurious life atop the W residences in Lower Manhattan, where she stayed with a friend. Unknown to many, though, behind the lavish lifestyle hid a dark reality. The woman was allegedly financed by wealthy men in exchange for bedroom favors, including a Russian oligarch who paid for her high-end apartment and showered her with luxury items. The man, who only became known as A among her trusted friends, even flew her across the globe just to spend time with him.
I was like, yeah, she's hot. She's got a Russian billionaire giving her money. Like, good for her. I get to enjoy it too. You know, I got free rent.
However, this arrangement came to an end in 2015 when Kat suffered from a serious bacterial infection that resulted in a mastectomy. In addition to her health issues, she was also in grief due to her mother's passing after a lengthy battle with cancer. The blows to her personal life ended her modeling career prematurely, forcing the resilient woman to look for other means to survive. It was at this point that Kat's career took a different turn. She fully embraced becoming an influencer, and by 2016 was able to amass a following. Her modeling success, magazine features, and Hollywood connections gave her an air of credibility that she used to monetize her growing number of followers. The same year, she married Colborne Bell, an artist and entrepreneur known in the crypto space as the founder of the Museum of Crypto Art. Together, they worked on growing Kat's brand by venturing into the wellness and life coaching space. Her website made bold claims, offering potential clients the love, self-esteem, and financial success they had always dreamed of. For $150, clients could book exclusive coaching sessions where Kat claimed she could solve any problem, promising to help people manifest their dreams into reality. Her techniques involved a mix of hypnosis, meditation, and exercise routines, all packaged in a subscription service that provided access to videos on relationships, wellness, business success, and spirituality. To bolster her new persona, Kat drew inspiration from various self-help gurus and spiritual leaders. She traveled across Brazil with her husband, exploring different religious practices. One figure who captivated her was John of God, a self-proclaimed medium and healer. However, the man was eventually sentenced to 118 years in prison for numerous cases of violating his followers dating back to 1973 until his arrest in 2018. Kat also idolized Tony Robbins, an American life and business coach. She attended his conferences and incorporated elements of his teachings into her own. Furthermore, her involvement in Hollywood circles introduced her to ayahuasca ceremonies, which involved drinking a hallucinogenic Amazonian tea. This soon became a significant part of her self-help persona. Unlike others who used the tea sparingly, Kat claimed to drink it monthly, believing it enhanced her abilities as a medium. However, people close to her began noticing the negative changes the substances had on her mentality and personality, leading to the eventual dissolution of her marriage and friendships. In February 2017, she published her autobiography, The Voice. The book detailed her journey of overcoming her past and achieving spiritual growth, along with claims of her ability to predict the future due to mystical voices that communicated with her. She promoted the book on Brazilian talk shows, claiming that it was written while she was in a trance. Kat's personal story of surviving violence in her youth struck a chord with women who had endured similar experiences. Her story gave them hope, and she became an example to them of how they could also turn their life around. Because of this, many of these vulnerable women disclosed their deepest insecurities and desires to Kat, believing she held the answers to their problems. One of them was Anna, a Brazilian woman who also experienced a difficult childhood and went to the US in search of a better life. She discovered Kat in 2017 during a low point in her life and found strength in her words. Drawn by the influencer's apparent success and wisdom, Anna made the life-altering decision to give up her university studies in Boston and move to New York to become Kat's leave-in assistant in 2019. She was promised a salary of $2,000 a month for doing housework and looking after the ex-model's pets. However, upon arriving in New York, she was faced with a different version of the influencer. The apartment was messy and smelled bad because of the pets, and even Kat appeared disheveled, a stark contrast to her polished social media presence. Making matters worse, the ex-model soon became highly dependent on her, requiring assistance even for basic tasks like showering. Anna found herself working all the time, only resting when Kat was out for appointments or with her boyfriend. However, once the woman returned, she had to be awake and ready to be at her service. Amidst these, she was not paid for her services. When Anna brought this up, the influencer became aggressive and used her knowledge of the woman's traumatic past to manipulate her. Finally, after three harrowing months, Anna managed to escape by moving in with a new boyfriend. However, it took over a year of therapy for her to break free from the woman's psychological hold on her. Meanwhile, Kat's online influence continued to grow. Many of her clients felt seen and understood for the first time. They became dependent on her guidance, turning to her before making any decision. This influence made it possible to sell every merchandise she released in her online store, making Kat a lot of money in the process. With her success, she dreamed even bigger and rented a 5-bedroom home in Austin, Texas. In 2022, she moved into this home with her new husband, Zachary Menken, a 21-year-old man from California. It was at this point that Kat's methods became more aggressive. She increased her consultation fees and began recruiting her most loyal followers to join her in Texas. One of these longtime followers was Desiree Freitas, a Brazilian woman living in Germany at the time as part of a school exchange program. She had been taking advice from the influencer for years and even broke up with her boyfriend upon Kat's advice. To convince her to move to Texas, the ex-model contacted Desiree in tears, creating a story about her poor health and bad emotional state. After a 2-hour conversation, Kat bought the plane tickets, leaving no room for discussion for the woman, who had no idea of the difficult life awaiting her in Texas. Once there, Kat conducted numerous sessions with Desiree, where she convinced the woman that she had to work as a dancer in a gentleman's club to prove to God that she could do anything for her dream. According to her, the mystical voice speaking to her revealed that Desiree would meet a wealthy man in this club who would give her a luxurious life. Fully convinced of Kat's supernatural powers, the woman worked full-time as a dancer in a men's club. She was a hit among the clients and made $9,000 in tips in her first 2 weeks. She turned over this money to Kat for safekeeping along with her passport, fearing that someone might discover that she was working in the country illegally. However, her work hours and the life coach's constant demand for her to make more money took a toll on the woman's health, prompting her to ask Kat if she could quit and just focus on helping with her coaching business. To her surprise, the life coach's response was jarring. She guilt-tripped Desiree for the money she spent on her tickets, accommodation, food, and sessions, even saying that the woman was only hired and kept safe from deportation because of Kat's witchcraft. Kat then threatened the poor woman that she would be charged for everything if she decided to leave and would be cursed if she did not pay. Without her passport and money, Desiree was forced to stay. Meanwhile, another woman, Sol, saw Kat's offer as a great opportunity. She was a tarot reader and yoga teacher but was homeless at the time. She moved from Boston to Austin after being promised compensation for her help with the wellness business. However, like Anna before her, Sol was subjected to round-the-clock domestic work without pay. The same was the case for Leticia Alvarenga, a 21-year-old woman from Brazil who left her studies to join Kat's coaching program but was relegated to work without pay for the woman's business. Their life in the influencer's Austin home was strictly regimented. The women were required to be awake from 5 a.m. until 2 a.m. the next day. They were not allowed to communicate with each other and could not leave their rooms without Kat's permission. Adding to the atmosphere of fear, Kat's husband kept 6 guns in the house. As the business grew and more women stayed in the house, Kat introduced new revenue streams, charging followers for spiritual baths with exorbitant fees reaching $10,000. During these private sessions, she or one of her assistants would convince the clients to stay in Austin to work with them. Kat also encouraged Desiree and the other women to offer services to men for money, arguing that even the models and celebrities she worked with before earned millions through this. Fearing what would happen if she refused, Desiree gave in. Kat set up her profile on escort websites and set a daily target of $3,000, which forced Desiree to sleep on the street whenever she failed to meet the quota. Through this questionable work, Desiree transferred more than $21,000 into Kat's bank account in June and July 2022 alone. As her use of ayahuasca continued, Kat's social media posts became increasingly disturbing, with her posts even claiming that she was Jesus. In one post, she threatened her former assistant Anna, calling her a traitor and asking her followers to attack her. Terrified, Anna reported Kat to the police on March 31, 2022. Saul, who had escaped thanks to an ex-boyfriend, also filed a report. But unfortunately, law enforcement did not take their claims seriously, and no investigation was launched. By September 2022, however, the families of Desiree and Letitia became worried after completely losing contact with them. The women had blocked most of their contacts and obeyed Kat's every command, even bleaching their hair until they resembled the supposed guru's blonde locks. Having no idea where the women were, their families launched a social media campaign and reported them as missing to the police. As the story spread on Instagram and Brazilian news, Anna knew she couldn't stand by silently. Believing these women were held in Kat's home, she contacted law enforcement and even made an online report to the FBI, exposing everything she knew about Kat's operation. In turn, Kat launched a defense, posting several Instagram videos claiming she only wanted to help the women by giving them jobs. She even ordered Desiree and Letitia to post videos, asking people to stop trying to locate them and claiming they were exercising their free will.
Eita, a última vez que eu vi eles, eu falei, não me procura mais. Não me procura mais, eu não quero mais falar com vocês. Quantas vezes eu vou ter que falar? Quantas vezes?
However, people speculated that Kat used ayahuasca, along with hypnotism and manipulation, to keep the women under her control. While ayahuasca can have transformative healing benefits when used responsibly, it can also be used by unscrupulous individuals to manipulate vulnerable people. As the family's worry intensified, they discovered the women's escort profiles, confirming their fears that they were being used. With a sense of urgency, they located Kat's Austin address, only to find that the devious woman had already taken her victims to another house in Maine. On November 1st, 2022, Detective David Davil from Maine received a tip from a Homeland Security investigation about a potential human trafficking operation. Because of this time, Kat received a FaceTime call from Davil, checking on the women's welfare. She was on the road with her victims at the time, and unbeknownst to her, one of these women started recording Kat even before the call. In the video, she was heard warning the victims about the detectives and threatening to hurt them.
Gente, eles são muito truqueiro. Ele é detetive. Muito cuidado, pelo amor de Deus. Eu vou dar um chute daqui em vocês se vocês falarem alguma coisa. Dá um grito.
Eu não.
The road trip was apparently to illegally cross the border to Canada using falsified documentation. However, the tip led Kat to be arrested by the police. She was deported back to Brazil, where she faced charges of human trafficking, unlawful labor, and medical fraud. Finally, in December 2022, Letitia and Desiree were reunited with their families, allowing them to cooperate with the authorities. Kat's first trial happened in January 2024 regarding Desiree's case. Almost 20 women who have also been scammed or exploited by Kat testified in the closed-door trial in April 2024. While waiting for her verdict, Kat was interviewed by the BBC. Instead of showing remorse for her actions, she refused to take accountability and called her victims liars. The self-proclaimed medium believed she would be freed soon, because there was no evidence against her. She also denied keeping any of the women in her house, despite countless Instagram posts and videos of her encouraging women to stay with her.
People were saying
I am a fake guru, but at the same time, they're also saying that I'm so real and so dangerous that I can take his mind, or whoever's mind, and change his mind.
With a lack of regard for the people she victimized, Kat stood by all her words and did not believe that the women were traumatized by her actions. Instead, she accused them of using her to gain media attention. The court, however, had a different opinion, and on June 28, 2024, Kat Torres was sentenced to 8 years in prison for subjecting Desiree to human trafficking and unlawful labor. As of this writing, investigations into more allegations brought about by other women are still ongoing in Brazil, which could lead to other convictions for the disgraced ex-model. Meanwhile, several of the victims have struggled to move on and regretted investing their lives in Kat's bogus teachings. Despite the trauma, they continue to fight to find meaning in their ordeal. With this in mind, Desiree wrote a book detailing her struggles, which she hoped would serve as a warning to other women. Anna went to therapy and found work as a nutritionist, while Sol had her friend's support as they helped her save funds for accommodation while she studied for a career in law enforcement. Lastly, Letitia continued her studies and fixed her relationship with her family. Because of the actions of Kat Torres, law enforcement acknowledged that the rise of social media has created a huge communication network, allowing traffickers to easily take advantage of more people. They advise the public to be wary of who they trust online, especially those offering a cure-all for their problems.
Human traffickers aren't always like in the movies where you have maybe a gang or that kidnap people. It's far more common that it's someone you trust.
For now, while she awaited further judgment and consequences for her actions, Kat Torres's story serves as a chilling warning about how the online community can hide sinister people who remain unapologetic despite the cruelty they inflict on others for personal gain.
You choose to believe whatever you choose to believe. I can tell you I'm Jesus, and you can see Jesus or you can see the devil. That's it.
Subscribe to watch more videos like this. Turn on notifications and leave a like to help the channel out. Thank you for watching.